Okay, so I'm gonna go tell Pisha we have the fish she wanted. And we're gonna see what artifacts she gives us in exchange.
Yes.
Here's the iron from the museum.
Yes. This is genuine and of use to me. There is something resonating from it. A whisper. I will give you this in trade. It is known as the Odious Chalice. It swells with spilled blood and offers its bloat to its owner.
Great. I'll be back if I find anything else. So, the Odious Chalice. So this is going to be very useful in our journey. The perverse creation of a Shemitzi fleshcrafter. This abomination is forced to live a tortured an eternity in servitude to the damned. As you kill enemies, the chalice will fill with blood. Use the chalice to feed from it and gain its store of vitae. Very helpful in our journey. And we'll save some blood packs. Although it does require us to kill our enemies too, but I think coming up next, this will serve us really well. We're going to be getting into more combat situations soon. Now, I was gonna go back to Damsel, but I think I wanna grab my money, talk to Heather first, and also grab the research books to increase our burglary up. Yeah, sorry, that's how we look. Alright. Oops. We might as well check our email too. See if there's anything I need. Alright, let's see if she's enchanted with us. Mm-hmm. No. You look like my deceased sister, oh my god. Yeah, no.
I don't usually flirt.
My goodness, you have a lot in common with my dog.
Are you undressed? Hello there.
This is horrible, I hate it.
Really?
Yeah, it must be your smell. It must be fantastic.
I tell you. Hello there. Really? Me?
Yes, I want to show you what's... Show me what's under your clothes. Mm-hmm. Okay, this worked apparently. Thank goodness for that. I don't know how it works, but who cares? We don't care right now. This system is weird. My goodness, why? I guess she does.
Money, though. Been a while. You want gas? Here. Does that make a difference?
It sure does. Thank you. Alright. Let's get out of here. Well, we have nice level of persuasion now. We have persuasion 7. Very useful. And if we get another level of presence, we'll get persuasion 8. Very handy. Yeah, we haven't got anything yet. Haven't done any hacking yet. I'm a bit disappointed I wasn't able to find that online banking thing in the terminal. It's weird. Oh well. Doesn't really matter. But I could have sworn the hotfix notes they said they did have that, but never mind. Stolen artifact. Our Karn sarcophagus stolen from the museum.
Oh, you're back. I went out this evening and I met someone and he wouldn't leave me alone, so he came back here with me and, well, I thought you might want to drink his blood.
I love coming home to find dinner waiting. Thank you, my pet.
I'm just glad you're pleased. He's in the bathroom. Don't worry, I locked him in.
I'll go help myself. Alright. Alright. We have another email. A gambit. A gambit has been played. The king leaves himself open. Ooh. Oh, business in Hollywood. I have a certain financial interest in a restaurant in Hollywood called the Calanti Cafe. I have made an offer on the establishment that is more than generous, but it seems that the owners are remiss to accept. It is my understanding that a renowned food critic named Tommy Fladon will be writing an article about the restaurant very soon. Please intercept him there and make sure the review is unfavorable. Ah, okay. Nice to do that. We can do that. Alright, well, I don't really need dinner. But I do need a humanity point.
What the hell is this shit? Let me out, goddammit! I'll kill that crazy bitch!
Look, my sister's she's a little nuts. I'll let you go, if you forget about this.
Psycho bitch brought me here, hit me in the head, and locked me up. What the fuck? I mean, who the fuck does that?
Well, only because you tried to rape her, at least that's what she'll tell the cops.
Oh, so she's gonna play it like that, huh? Alright. Alright, just let me out. I want to get as far away from that crazy bitch as possible.
There. Once again, I'm very sorry. I'm not hungry at the moment. He's very unpleasant. Prefer to seduce my prey. But I'm not going to reprimand her for it. She did try to do a good thing for me. But I need the humanity points.
It's you. Earlier tonight, you weren't following me, were you? I had this feeling like I was being watched. Maybe it's nothing, but I'm still a little shook up.
It wasn't me. It could be one of the number of people who want me dead. Deader.
Want you dead? Why? How could anyone think of harming someone so extraordinary?
Well, it's some... Okay, so we have a choice here. This will affect if we are able to keep Heather alive. But it will, if we tell her to stay in stores, she'll be safe for the rest of the game. We'll never have to worry about her. But we won't get the final armor for free. And to be honest, I would really like the final armor for free. And hey, our character wants her to really keep her to keep giving them nice gifts. Somebody who you don't know approaches you, shoot them in the head.
If they're after you, yes, I'll do it. I just need to learn how to use a gun first.
You do that.
I will.
And of course we could just let her convince her to leave. Again, this will give you an extra humanity point. Okay, change your appearance.
Okay.
Gothic. So yes, I'm basically condemning her to die. Unless I choose to change my mind and say she should leave my service. We'll see. I think it's unlikely I will change my mind. But we'll find out. Gotcha, I better reload this gun. Make some good use of it. Alright. Let's go and buy some books. I think we could use, we're gonna really increase our lot picking capabilities. And if I have some spare money, I might buy an unarmed book too. So, yeah, we have literacy 6, so we're good.
Welcome back, young canine.
You know what? I keep forgetting to ask him some questions. May I ask you a few questions?
Perhaps.
What can you tell me? Can you tell me a little about yourself?
What is there to tell? I am an open book. You need just learn to read.
Come on, I really would like to know more.
If you must. My name is Akim al-Qasim ibn Ali al-Hariri. In my mortal life, I used to be a Muslim priest, a scholar, and a poet.
Nice!
It seems my passion for education has drawn the attention of the local Assamite vizier in the area of the Aral Sea.
I see.
So, long story short, I was embraced and thus given the chance to continue my pursuit of knowledge for a while longer.
How long ago were you embraced?
I believe about 400 years ago, give or take a few decades.
Do you like being a vampire?
If not for one, I could not answer that question. So you figure it out.
Hell? Okay, we already know how long he was embraced. What sect are you from?
None. I consider myself a freelance book trader.
Very cool. That's very cool. Maybe change the subject?
Perhaps.
By the way, if you were playing as an Asimite, you can talk to him about being a vizier caste Asimite yourself, and he actually gives you a bonus in scholarship, or linguistics in this case. So, very handy. So, if you wanted to have that fourth or fifth point from Beckett, you could either get Akeem to give you that third or fourth point for free. So, something to think on. Can you tell me about the independent clans?
Of course. Which clan are you interested in?
I would like to know about the Asimites.
We Asimites are the nobles of the Middle East. Despite enjoying a rather foul reputation of assassins and diabolists here in the West, most of us are in truth guardians and scholars. I myself am a vizier. We are the caste of artists and mentors. Most of us are dedicated to seeking knowledge and inspiration, and to preserving it. A rather noble quest, I believe.
And this is where you can reveal to him that you're of the vizier caste, and he'll be like, oh my goodness, and that's where he'll give you that extra point of linguistics. Seems like it. May I ask you about another clan?
Of course. Which clan are you interested in?
Can you tell me about the Bali?
The Bali are nothing more than bitten demon worshippers and infernalists who seek greater power through communion with otherworldly entities. Stay away from them, young friend, for they are wretched, power-hungry, and treacherous. Give them the chance, and they will not hesitate to use you, curse you, and corrupt you.
Good to know. I'd like to learn about a different clan.
Of course.
What's behind the followers of Set?
The Sithites firmly believe that the founder of their clan was the ancient Egyptian god Set. Preparing for his return to one day consume the world, the Sithites spent most of their nights seeking to reduce the influence of both the Sabbat and the Camarilla, polishing their skills in corruption, deceit, and ancient sorcery.
Hey, I don't corrupt and deceive too much.
Then learn quickly, Sithite. These skills will no doubt prove useful to you, and before long.
I'll look into it. Tell me about another clan.
Of course. Which clan are you interested in?
I'd like to know about another clan.
Sure.
I would like to know more about the Ishkari.
The Glutons are the African branch of the Toreador bloodline and the artists and visionaries of the Libo, claiming to be descendants of the Babylonian goddess Ishtar. They spend most of their time spying, gathering information, and forging alliances. These kindred share the weakness of the Ravnus in that each Ishtari has a unique vice that they inevitably must indulge, lest it drives them mad.
Cool. I have another clan I'd like to ask about.
Of course. Which clan are you interested in? Sure.
I would like some information about the Uzbo.
The Osebo carry the nickname the
Pride Osebo, okay. For a reason. I've been saying
not
it wrong
only
the whole
time. Are they amongst the most fierce warriors of Africa, but like the members of their parent clan, Ruha, they are more prone to giving in to the beast within and indulging their taste for kidnapping, rape, and murder.
Oh, make sure to steer clear of them. Tell me about another clan.
Of course. Sure.
What should I know about the Salubri?
Known to most other clans as diabolic and corrupt, the Salubri are in truth perhaps the most noble clan amongst all canines. Healers, mystics, and scholars, the Salubri spend their unlife in search for the path to Golconda, the mysterious ancient city where the father of their bloodline, Solot, reportedly found serenity and inner peace.
That's cute. I'd like to learn about another clan.
Of course. Sure.
Do you know anything about the Semedi? I hope I'm saying that right.
There's a good reason why the Samedi look and smell like rotting corpses. They are.
Hey, I've been saying
impossible
right.
to blend into mortal society, possibly due to the pieces of rotting flesh always falling off of them. They are mostly loners that don't care about any sect or politics, seeking solitude in their study of death, which they seem to be quite obsessed with.
They sound disgusting. Let's move on to it. Well, actually, may I ask you another question?
Perhaps.
I have other questions.
Sure.
Tell me about the Jihad.
The Jihad is the darker, more sinister cousin of human politics, the social application of canine's lust for power. In most kindred societies, there are a number of rules and laws that regulate the relations of its members. Violating them makes one susceptible to brutal and fatal punishment.
Go on.
Thus, any direct hostile approach toward your enemies within your clan or sect could easily result in you violating these rules and finding yourself on the receiving end of the axe. So, to get those that oppose you dispossessed or destroyed, you must instead weave secret plots against them. Wrap them up in intrigue, treachery, and deceit.
I'm listening.
And they respond accordingly. And it goes back and forth until one of you makes the wrong move and falls. And then someone else takes up the vacant spot. And it starts all over again. That, my young friend, is the Jihad.
Wow, I had no idea. Thanks.
Sure.
What's with that Gehenna thing?
Gehenna is supposed to be the night in which the clan's forefathers, the Antediluvians, shall wake up and consume the world. In my personal opinion, this is nothing but an interesting symbiosis of superstition, misunderstood prophecies, and wishful thinking.
So he shares a similar opinion to Beckett.
Will the Antediluvians indeed wake up one day? Well, possibly. But from there it gets rather delusional. And if they wake up, so what? Antediluvians coexisted in peace and harmony with their own bloodlines for centuries. They have awakened from their torpor so many times in the past, and did they consume the world? Apparently not.
I'm listening.
In any case, the historian named Beckett too tends to dismiss its credibility, and he knows more about kindred lore than any of us. Maybe you should ask him, shall you ever have the chance to meet him, that is.
Oh, you know Beckett?
Yes. He has been a very useful source of information to me regarding my area of interest on several occasions in the past, and so have I been to him, I dare believe.
He seems to know a lot.
It seems to me that you have already met the Lone Wolf. Interesting. Despite his rugged appearance, he is among the more noble of our kind. You would do well to heed his advice, young child.
Oh, consider it. Let's talk about something else.
Sure. Perhaps.
I don't have any questions.
Welcome back. Choose.
Yeah. Okay, so this, we can actually read this, but we just need melee too, but I don't want to. Alright. Yeah, that was an interesting conversation.
Choose.
Okay. Ooh, actually, I think we could probably get that unarmed book.
Welcome. Choose what?
Yeah. Let's do that. I will need to sell some stuff, though.
Welcome. Choose what?
Which I think I will. Because I don't think I can afford it right now. Ooh. Something's growling. Okay, I think I have enough now. Sweet. Oh, that's great. Haha. Now our unarmed skill is up to 5. And our security is up to... well, burglary is up to 6. I think we'll get ourselves some money now. And that was some really interesting lore. And corruption. Well, we'll be getting to our path of corruption. We were just playing innocent there. Okay. And also, Yeah, I wanted to do this before meeting up with Damsel because I want to rob the fridge that Brother Cranker had.
Oh, darn, I really need some extra money.
Oh, don't worry, we'll be getting some money soon. And we'll be able to rob Gimbal's box in Santa Monica, same thing with Dennis's box as well. So we're gonna be doing good in terms of money. Yeah, I think we're gonna be fine. I was a bit concerned, but I think we're gonna be good. I'm going to be getting I'm gonna get the stealth books next. I'm not sure what other books I'm gonna get next. I think for me at the moment our build is actually pretty solid. I feel to me. If I need to get more persuade, I will of course buy some more charisma and maybe put my presence up. So it's nice though. Okay. Alright. Well, I think we need to tell Damsel this important news, so let's talk to Jack too. See what other advice he has. I'm not gonna sell the shotgun this time because I actually need it here for this next section. Sweet. Got some meal. Thank you, sir. He's doing us a really nice favor by doing that. Now, I could put my dexterity up so I can get my burglary up to 7, naturally, so I can lockpick that chest in Strauss's place. And I'll think about it. I think I would like to do that. It'd be nice to rob from him without any consequences, but we'll see. First, let's go here first. I don't think Damsel needs to smell us from being in the sewer.
Heard anything?
The prince is really interested in getting the Ankara sarcophagus.
It's probably just like the rolls of coffins or something. Lousy bastard.
I'll let you know when I have more news.
I heard you were down poking around the museum.
I was there to get the sarcophagus.
Seems like he has a lot riding on that sarcophagus. To get such a fierce bug in that powdered wig of his.
And why'd you think that is?
I got another scenario for you here, kiddo. Gonna bounce it off you, see what you think. You ever hear of, Diablery?
I think I might have. But please go into more detail. What is that?
Well, it's when a vampire drains another more powerful vampire to death. Diablery is the Sabbat's specialty, but it's a big taboo in civilized kindred circles, and damn sure forbidden by the Camarilla.
Why is this so taboo?
When a younger vampire diablerizes an elder, the younger vampire gains all of their powers.
Wow, you don't think...
The prince is willing to tear L.A. apart to find this thing so he can have it. Why? What would a power-hungry vampire like LaCroix want with a sleeping ancient? I wonder.
I don't wonder how you knew he was already in a sniff about it. Jack, did you tell LaCroix that Nines was... Tell Nines that LaCroix was gunning for him? Trying to frame him for the murder of Vals de Grau? What should I do? He wants me to bring it to him.
You gotta figure a drop of ancient blood would make any kindred just about invulnerable. Anyone who has a sarcophagus is gonna be thinking the same thing. If LaCroix gets a sarcophagus, at least we know where it is.
Yeah, I guess.
Besides, getting the sarcophagus and getting into it are two different things.
I swear, Jack knows quite a bit, huh? I am a little intrigued that somehow he knows quite a bit. I don't know, he just seems to have really great sources. He knows a lot, because he has some sources on the inside or...
What?
I swear he knows a lot. I mean, he knows that Laquan's upset. I mean, I guess he heard rumors about it, and we already know why Laquan's upset, but still. He knows a lot. I find it very interesting he knows so much. So that's 5 of you. But still, I mean, Jack is being very helpful. He has some advice for us. And again, I'm sorry, I haven't been using my guns lately. I probably will be really soon once I get into Hollywood. There's gonna be some situations that I might want to use my guns for. I said might, though. And we have free blue blood packs. Very handy. Again, lockpicking is super useful here. Like, getting it really high is great. But of course, I'm not gonna pay for these two levels. No point. I'd rather spend the money just to do it. Anyway. Oh man, these clothes are just getting dirty. Can't wait to go into Hollywood and get ourselves a new outfit. Although it's probably going to be a bit expensive, but it's okay. I'm sure we can find our scrounge some money up or whatever, or sell whatever we have on hand. Okay. I'm trying to think what else we could actually buy. Besides buying a new piece of armor and probably buying those stealth books, I think we should save some money up just in case a particular nice item comes into our possession. I think that's something we need to work on. Oops. I just didn't cling to me like that. Oh well. Let's see, we have a free man. Alright. Let's go to Hollywood.
Need a ride?
Yeah, just drive. Alright. Oops. Well, let's look for... Oh,
ain't seen you there before. If I haven't seen you, neither is Isaac. So that's your next stop.
Where can I find him?
Isaac's in the jewelry store at the end of the street. Consider yourself invited.
I'll head over there. Okay, we've got ourselves a watch, and if you do actually go into a building, he is very insistent on you actually going to see Isaac, so I don't want to test him. Pardon me, really does want to actually put this up. I also like phobia, too. Oh! I believe that's Tommy Flata.
More flatbread and olive oil. And take back the Chardonnay and open up a Chianti. Let it breathe for 20 minutes, and then bring it out with a ziti. Okay?
I just wanted to...
Wanted to know what? Interrupt me while I'm working? Do you understand that this is an important opening, and I, emphasize I, am going to make or possibly break this restaurant?
I thought I'd say hi.
Hello. Now go get yourself some onion rings or hot wings or whatever it is you eat. The refined palate of a true gourmand is, to put it in a language you can relate to, trying to decide if this place is thumbs up or thumbs down.
Who are you?
Me, Tommy Flayton, the food authority of Los Angeles, food critic for the biggest paper on the West Coast, radio personality for the KTLK, Chower Hour? Maybe if I reviewed more pancake huts, you'd know me.
Just the man I wanted to talk to.
I'm not sure exactly what you mean.
By the way, you might have noticed that I didn't flirt with him. As a woman, it's not gonna work on him. He's not interested in women, but if you're a man, however, wink, wink, nudge, nudge, isn't it in your best interest to pan this place? You've got a reputation to keep.
How so?
I saw the chef in the bathroom. He didn't even look in the sink.
This place will pay for this. As sure as my name is Tommy Flayton, they'll never serve food in this town again.
Give them hell, Tommy. Bye. Fantastic. Well, we ruined that guy's reputation. This place's reputation. Oh, there he is. Another blue blood pack. He's just hanging out here. I didn't know he did that here.
I could have swore I told you to see the Baron. Yeah, that was a laugh. Except my sense of humor is a little askew, you know? Conflict just cracks me the hell up.
Alright. I'll go see him. I guess I didn't need to talk to him. Hello.
Good evening, Neonate. Isaac Abrams. I've been expecting you. Seems the wooden soldiers of the Camarilla shuffle in a little too often these nights. That baby-faced two-bit Prince LaCroix got something to say to me?
I'm looking for the Nosferatu.
So, you've come to barter information with the sewer rats. LaCroix must really be desperate if he stooped to consorting with their kind. And asking for my help, of all peoples.
Many people in the Camarilla tend to consort with the Nosferatu because they're great informational brokers, but you know. Any idea where I can find them?
Perhaps. However, before we discuss how I might help you, there is the matter of tribute.
I don't like where this conversation is headed.
Call me old-fashioned, but this is my barony, and as is tradition, a token of respect must be paid.
I see. What do you want?
What I want is a simple exchange. Last week I paid for a certain item, a movie, and this evening I got an email saying that the seller is ready to deliver it. Unfortunately, he's become a bit paranoid all of a sudden. Won't meet me in person, won't drop it off, won't even answer his phone. Says he'll send the location of the pickup to a computer in the nearby internet cafe tonight. You see where I'm going with this?
You want me to make the pickup? Easy enough.
Go to the Ground Zero Internet Cafe. Look for a directory named Joseph K and use the password Kafka. There'll be an email in there that will specify a nearby location. Meet the contact, pick up the item, come back. Not too painful, right?
I'll head there immediately. Then we'll discuss my issue.
Excellent. In the meantime, consider yourself a welcome guest in my barony. Welcome to Hollywood.
Thanks. Alright, well, we'll just head over right over there, and we'll be fine, and...
Oh my gosh, is that you? Everyone was worried sick about you. When you didn't show up and didn't call and nobody knew anything about what happened to you, we thought you were dead. Are you okay? You know what? Never mind. We have to help you.
Who are you?
It's me, Samantha. Don't you... Did you suffer amnesia? Is that it? Let me make a call. We'll get everybody together. We can talk. Maybe you'll remember something. The important thing is that they know that you're alive.
You never saw me, Samantha. I'm dead. This is how you will remember me.
I'm sorry. I've made a terrible mistake. That person I mistook you for, I just remembered they died.
I'm sorry for your loss. Excuse me. Well, we managed to preserve the masquerade that way. But if she does actually try to go to the phone, you can't just feed on her. You don't have to kill her, you just have to feed on her long enough to... She'll forget it. When a kindred actually feeds on a human, they do tend to forget the last few minutes, I suspect, of the feeding. Okay, so normally the computer would be right here, but they actually moved the computer in here. An email. Kafka. Oh, probably spelled that wrong. Okay, meet me in the alley behind the fast book. Virus alert. That Mav has detected a virus in the attachment in the sea. Okay. Ah, I see. Well, we better rob their bank, too. Okay. Oops. Wrong one. I'm sure it'll be fine. I mean, it's not like he'll be able to make his money back. I'll wait on that one. Maybe we shouldn't rob that guy. Or should we? I'll rob him later. But I'm just gonna put that in. Alright. Yeah, I really need some blood soon. Whew. Very hungry. Hello?
Yeah? What do you want?
Are you the guy with the tape? Isaac sent me.
Yeah? I mean, what? Who the hell is Isaac? I don't know anyone named Isaac. Get lost, bitch!
You sure you don't know him? He won't be happy if I go back empty-handed.
Alright. Sorry. It's just that... I mean, something is... I just want out of this whole thing. I don't want anything to do with that damn tape.
Why? What's going on?
I don't know. I mean, when it comes to video, I've seen everything. And I do mean everything. But this thing, it's sick. It can't be real, but it is. I know it. It's real, and it scares the hell out of me.
Really? Is it that bad?
Oh, you have no idea. It's disgusting. That girl, the things that are happening to her, it just ain't right, man. It just ain't right. No. Something's wrong. Something's after me. I swear to God, something's after me.
What are you talking about?
Every place I go, wherever I look, I see things. In the shadows. My phone rings. I hear something breathing on the other end and... Shit. I'm out, man. I'm out of this whole thing.
All right. Just give me the tape.
I don't have it. I stashed it someplace. Look, you need to find Ginger Swans. Huh? What the hell was that? Oh, shit. Did you see that? I'm getting the fuck out of here.
What the? Oh, Christ!
Something happened. Let's find out, and... he's gone. Is that his arm? I mean, it's probably likely. Fuck. Oh dear. Something grabbed him. That's screwy. Oh boy. Ginger Swans. I feel like we gotta look this up. I guess I could ask Isaac about it, but... Okay, why'd she do that? I don't know. But that does mean we can hack his computer, but I think we'll just, we'll just figure this out.
The moon is out, everyone's in dreamland.
Another money clip. Useful. We need it. I'll just get a save. Hopefully he won't. Clerk won't notice that's feeding on this woman. I really need food. Okay. Great. Fantastic. Okay. Hello.
What's up? Welcome to Red Spot, home of the Monstro Chug. 72 ounces of your favorite beverage for 89 cents, blah, blah. You need help or something?
Yeah. What's going around here. Anything exciting or unusual?
Always. You should come out and see my band, A Bowl of Cereal. We're playing tomorrow night at the crematorium. No cover for chicks. We're going to ruin the place.
Interesting. Anything else I should know about?
Yeah. The Vesuvius rocks. They don't let me in anymore, but damn the girls in there, dude. It's like a midget smuggling ring in there. If you're into that kind of thing, I mean.
Possibly.
Hey, you know, you should really ask me about the special, you know?
Okay, I'll bite. What's the special?
I'm glad you asked that, baby. Seeing as how you look trustworthy or something, I got this special where you buy some really expensive burrito tots or grapele juice. You get a free weapon of your choice, bro. You interested?
Oh, of course. Show me what you got. I think Heather could use a burrito. Okay. Okay, there are a lot. This is a little bit more expensive than what I had before. Oops. Sorry about that. Anyone just saw this? I'm gonna get this, though. You're gonna see how much money you will save if you actually go for Inspection 9 in this playthrough. But that was another thing I wanted to ask him, but let's have a look at this. Ooh, this is pretty. I like this a lot.
Hola.
You hear anything about the new about the serial killer?
This isn't gonna turn out to be ironic, is it? You're not, like, a serial killer, are you?
No. What else is going on around here, I think?
Always.
Oh, yeah, we already know this. Okay, well, we'll talk to him later. I'm gonna have to take off this outfit at times because it does impede on my dexterity, which is kind of annoying when I need to do some lockpicking or sneaking, but for the moment, I'm good. Alright, actually, you know what? I'm gonna go over here. And then we'll go to the clinic. Oh my goodness, these guys are just a lot more everywhere. I guess it's handy for me since I need more blood, a lot more. Alright. But, okay. Alright, so I'm just gonna go around in the fast buck because there's some items I want to pick up from here to do with my inspection skill. It's a fancy ring here. Yeah, and same newspaper. Okay. Alright, so let's go to the internet cafe. Should I actually put my... I don't know. I don't know what to do. Should I put my perception up? Well, not perception. Presence. Or should I put this up? Oof. I really want to do both. Anyway, so this is what we could type in to find out. So, assuming like it's just like in the Bond's computer where the surname was the last... was what we want to be searching first. Ah, we have a ginger. Swan, a name synonymous with beauty and glamour to this day, was a great Hollywood of the late 40s and early 50s. Her credits include such movies as Gilded Hummingbirds and When No Means Yes. After her passing in 1954, she was interred in the Hollywood Forever Cemetery mausoleum. Okay, so we have a clue. Looks like we have to go. So it seems like the courier might have stashed a tape where her grave is. Or, you know, where her ashes are in the mausoleum. Anyway, so we got more bashing, of course. That's very helpful. It's like, isn't this like plus two, isn't it? Yeah, it's like plus two. It's gonna be more useful when we use my Sitite form. Or I use my blip buff. Alright. Huh, there's something glowing here. Oh, it's a gun! Remington M700. That's a lot of damage. Interesting. Alright, so I'm going to be doing a quest outcome. Now, I could do it one way if I wanted to be seductive, but I really want that fire on point. Alright, so actually, that free fire on point? Alright, so I'm going to test something. And I'm not going to keep it if it doesn't work, but... Yeah, we'll try it. I don't think it's going to work, though, because I think I tested it before and it didn't. I'm sorry.
Names
I'm
just...
I will be...
You're telling. I love.
I'm gonna do it. I will do it fairly.
Business. Really?
Yeah, I'll be right back. I just wanted to test it out. If it doesn't work, then I'll just do it normally. Sorry about this. Okay. I'm getting a bit of a spoiler in this conversation bit, but you know. Now, I had enough seduction where I could have potentially slept with him, but I won't get the firearm skill if I did that.
Hey. No. Oh. I don't know.
And we could have done dominate if we wanted to. But we prefer to persuade. I just love this skirt. I don't know, I'm just really into it. I just love how the skirt looks. You can always use a rifle.
Old Jim. Oh.
Oh, I see. Okay, so here's a bit of a difference here is... So I think we're gonna stick with the firearm skill we have currently, because I want the actual bonus.
Well there, Sugar Puss. Might want to think about knocking next time I damn near blew your hat off. Thought you might be a zombie.
Why would you think I was a zombie?
Who else would be waltzing in here in the middle of the night? Name's Romero. I'm the caretaker here. Well, that is, I don't exactly keep people from getting in, although that is part of my job. No. You see, I'm here to make sure nothing gets out.
What do you mean?
See, it's like this. Every night around this time for the past, several months now, the dead have been getting up with an itch to stroll down Hollywood Boulevard. Nobody knows why, but they're working on it. Till they figured out they needed a volunteer to patch the problem, and I stepped forward. Problem temporarily solved, the Baron's happy, I get to shoot zombies, and guarantee I get my blood for another month. I've carved out a nice niche here.
What's causing the zombies to rise?
Who knows? Vampire necro hoodoo, toxic waste, solar radiation. The important part is, they continue to rise up, and I get to put them down. Everybody's a winner.
Sounds like fun.
You're telling me. As far as I know, I'm the only person around Hollywood who considers marksmanship an art. A lot of the stiffs around here used to be asshole celebrities, too. Bonus. I love my job, what can I say? By the way, hey, you wouldn't be interested in watching the place while I go handle some business, would you? I'm not supposed to leave, or it might end up in a zombie holocaust or something. Like one time these goths snuck in? Ooh, wasn't pretty.
What do I have to do?
I know you're technically dead and all, but goddamn, you are one striking looking piece of ass. Where were you when you were still breathing, huh? I suppose you'd still be interested in a little,
I just might, but let's get back to business first.
Business, right. I was thinking I'd head up to the Strip and look for a dance partner for the old naughty tango. But, you're kind of giving it hot. Want to save me a trip?
I would love to, but the problem is, I would like that extra firearm skill. I'll save you the trip. I'll bring someone back for you.
Really? You will? Great. I'll just stay here and keep watch. Oh, and FYI, I like them a little, you know, stacked. Appreciate it.
I'll be back soon. Anyway, I better take this because I won't be able to have another chance to do it. Get myself some free ammo. Oh my goodness, I've got some nice free ammo. So again, if you have inspection higher, like 8, you probably could get the extra weapons and get yourself some nice extra ammo. For example, for that Magnum, you can get some extra ammo here. The 8 inspection special weapon in Santa Monica is, not Santa Monica, downtown, is the bush hook. Very nice. Very nice indeed.
Hey, honey. Looking for a date?
Yes, I am, but not for me. For a friend of mine.
Okay, I'll play along. Where's this friend of yours?
He is the caretaker of the cemetery.
Oh, no way am I going in there. What kind of freak are you?
I assure you, it'll be perfectly safe.
I don't know why I should believe you. Well, okay. But I'm gonna get really pissed if you turn out to be some psycho murderer. Let's go.
Follow me. Now, I could have dominated her into coming with me, but I really want to save the blood. Okay, I'm just popping over here. Okay. And again, yeah, I could have sex with Romero, and that would give me some XP, but unfortunately I wouldn't get the extra firearm point.
Hey. Very nice. What can I give you for the assist?
Could you help me improve my skill with firearms?
When you fire, keep your eyes on the target even after you shoot. And use the sight, that's what it's there for. And style doesn't count for jack if you can't hit anything. Keep that Glock to the side crap in the movies. Oh, would you look at the time? Me and, girl here got some Couch Olympics to compete in. So if you don't mind.
Have fun. And we won't be able to get in there at all, sadly. Now, if I wasn't playing a character who wasn't that interested in firearms, I would most certainly sleep with him if I had the seduction points. And in some mods, there are some mods where you can actually have more flirting options with male characters as a man. I think it's called Bachelor Masquerade. I believe that one is called. And in that one you can romance, or rather seduce, Romero. And some other characters too. Because it's actually quite limited. The female character in this game has more options, but there are some options that belong to the man only, to the male version. For example, we can, you know, you could seduce Tommy Flayton, but you also can seduce some female characters that we can't seduce as a female character, sadly. Alright, I forgot to actually hack the computer in the internet cafe, so why don't I do that now? And I know we gotta check out the Lucky Star Motel for a bounty. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna wait on that. And yeah, we don't have a ton of money, but we're slowly building up our means. Alright, let me just check over here. I don't think there's anything here for us. I think we've picked up most things. Well, there's a rat here. Don't worry, I will be using my seduction. I really want to, but I also could spend an extra point here. But that would just put me up to 7. And I do want an extra point in persuade. That would be super useful in conversations. You know what? Let's do it. And it's gonna help me really debuff my enemies. Like, it's like 4 -4 penalty to strength, wits, and perception, and reduced rate of attack. That's going to be super helpful for me.
made good time. Hand me the item.
Here.
I didn't doubt you'd find this. And I apologize if I was overly imperious before. A reflex action. I get a lot of young blood in here forgetting their place. I'll assist you as reasonably as I can with your task. But first, this tape. I'm in a hurry to find out what's behind all the hype, so get comfortable. I do have a feeling that whatever's here may be of use to both of us.
Oof, brutal.
It's more disturbing than I was led to believe. You can understand my concern now, can't you?
That was sick. Why the hell did I need to see that?
It just so happens that around the time this snuff film started circulating, the Nosferatu disappeared. I tried to elicit their help in tracking down the source, and for the first time in all these years, I was dismayed by their absence.
You think the tape has something to do with their disappearance?
I assume it does. It's awfully coincidental otherwise. And those creatures. I don't know how many professional FX houses could pull those off. There's a problem, though, in that the film's incomplete. The first half is damaged. We need a complete copy.
Where do we find a better copy?
Behind the spit-shine gloss of the Hollywood Dream Factory, there's another city churning out a vile byproduct for the furtive consumption of a debauched audience. I have no doubt the film's found its way to another smut peddler. I'd ask around.
Before I start looking, I have a few questions.
Certainly.
Anything I could do for you in the city?
There is something, but it involves a gargoyle. I can see that's got your attention.
Yeah, tell me about this gargoyle.
It's taken up residence in my beloved Asian theater. It is closed now, but that's beside the point. I sent some people to evict it, and it sent them back with a few less limbs. I can't have that monster attacking kindred in my city.
I'm interested, but how does one exactly deal with a gargoyle?
It's a walking block of stone with a taste for blood. I'd suggest whatever method doesn't result in you being eviscerated. In truth, I'd rather have it as an ally, but I doubt it's going to be chatty. Here's the key for the theater. I'll leave it up to you.
I'll see what I can do. I had another question.
Certainly.
Tell me about yourself.
In your lifetime, unwittingly or not, you have seen an Isaac Abrams production. As the financier of 30% of American film's top 100 movies, you must have. Being the Baron of Hollywood, I can do any project I want.
I'm impressed. Who's your favorite person you worked with?
Stewart, Lean, Hitchcock, Wilder, Holden, Dean, Scorsese, De Niro, and last but not least, Ash, my child. I remember some studio suit lost in time telling me the only thing they could use Bogart for was to move furniture.
Ash?
Ash. Where do I begin? 7 years ago, I saw a casting session for what would become Negative Zero. The moment I set eyes on him, the passion of his performance, I knew he had it.
Go on.
I hadn't seen anything like him since Clift or Dean. He had the looks, the charisma, the lure, that undefinable quality that makes a film legend. My first movie with him made him a sensation, and it also changed him.
How?
Once everyone knew who he was, I no longer did. The parties, the drinking, the sports cars, the women. One night when I came to discuss his next role, I found him nearly dead of an overdose. And I couldn't let him go.
You made him your child to save him?
I acted on impulse. I'd seen so many others die before their time, but with Ash, I had a chance to prevent that fate.
So what happened?
It devastated Ash. He still wanted to act, but I denied him his place in the limelight. He had to lie to his friends about his new lifestyle. He had to feed. I gave him a club, a scrap of his former glory. I did everything I could to facilitate the change.
Does he hate you?
He feels obligated to me. I don't think he hates me. Resents me, maybe. I am his sire and he is my child. There is a responsibility and respect inherent in that bond. Even if we are no longer the friends we were.
Where can I find Ash?
He spends nearly all of his nights in his club, the asshole. I am, I admit it, too old-fashioned to appreciate it. To me, it's the compressed essence of everything that's wrong with the film industry today.
Maybe I'll head over there sometime. I have some other questions.
Certainly.
What can you tell me about the Nosferatu?
The Nosferatu? I pity them, but I loathe their presence. I deal with them when it's necessary. I know they're beneath my city somewhere, but only they know where. They respect my streets, and I keep my politics out of their sewers. But I don't trust them by any stretch of the word.
Well, I better get back to looking for that tape later, Isaac. Okay, so I'm going to cut it here, and we're going to start looking for the spot places for, well, any possible news of a tape. Until